this point, we've learned a lot about the classical lifting line theory developed by Prandtl, which has formed the basis of our understanding of wing design over the last century. And it's also given us many rules of thumb for wing design and twist and planform shapes. And anyway, there's a lot to be learned from that theory. Well, that theory has some significant limitations. One of them being that it was only good for wings without sweep and dihedral. Okay, so the classical assumed no sweep and no dihedral. Now, if you go to an airport or look up pictures of modern aircraft online, you'll see that most airplanes have sweep and or dihedral on their main wing, and certainly other control surface or other lifting surfaces on the aircraft have dihedral, such as a vertical tail. So let's just review what this means here really quickly. So dihedral is a rigid body rotation of a wing. So if this is a wing with no dihedral, we're looking at it from the front here. Then once we add dihedral, that wing would be rotated. Okay, so that's a dihedral angle, and that's just a rigid body rotation of that wing segment or complete wing. So the most common place we see this is on the vertical tail of an aircraft. So you look at the empennage, and it usually looks something like this. If again we're looking at this from the front, so we've got the horizontal tail here, and then this is the vertical tail, and that usually has somewhere close to 90 degrees of dihedral. Now some fighter aircraft have like a V tail, or you know, you'll see different types of designs out there. But anyway, see something like that. But anyway, that's dihedral. That's just a rigid body rotation of this geometry. Sweep, on the other hand, is a little bit different. So sweep is actually a skewing of a wing. So if we look at a top-down view of a wing and say that this is the center line over here, if we add sweep to this wing, what happens is we skew this back. All right, so it looks something like this. And there are different ways to measure sweep. Some people report it as an angle from the leading edge, so that would be the leading edge sweep. And then you can also report it from the trailing edge. Now, those may be different angles depending on if you have taper in the wing. So I've drawn a rectangular wing here, but you can imagine that if you had a tapered wing, that those angles would be different. And still another angle that is often used is the angle between the original quarter chord line and the new quarter chord line. So that's another sweep angle. So all three of these are used. And as long as you know the geometry of the wing, you can transfer between these relatively easily. You can figure out what the leading edge sweep is, the trailing edge sweep, or the quarter chord sweep. And usually, when we're working with lifting line theory or this numerical algorithm that we'll be discussing, we use the quarter chord sweep angle. That's why I put it in blue here. That's the angle that will be, whenever I talk about sweep during these next few videos, we'll be talking about that quarter chord sweep angle. Sweep is actually a skewing of the wing. So you can see that the wingtip moved straight back here, and actually every wing section simply moves back and doesn't change its orientation. And so it's still the same distance out from the center line of that wing. It's just been skewed back. And this is similar to what you would see if you had a stack of pennies. So if we had a stack of pennies and we pushed on the side of this, you'd see these pennies kind of move over like this. Well, this is exactly what sweep does. It's just a skewing without a rotation of those pennies, so to speak, you know, or those wing sections. So that's different than dihedral. Dihedral is actually a rigid body rotation, and sweep is just a skewing. Okay, so anyway, the classical lifting line theory neglected both of these, or was it, we were not able to account for these in order to make that theory simple enough to solve through these analytic methods and through the infinite series methods. We had to restrict this to wings with no sweep and no dihedral. Well, in general, like I said, most aircraft have some sort of dihedral, some sort of sweep on them, and there are good reasons for that we'll learn about later. And so we need an algorithm that can account for that. And of course, you can go to full CFD. You can actually also go to panel codes that can account for these types of things. But today we're going to start talking about the numerical lifting line method, which is yet another method that's actually rather simple that can account for some of these effects, the dihedral and sweep. So we'll be talking about how to take the principles that we've learned from the classical lifting line theory and applying them now in a numerical fashion to solve for more complicated wing geometries.